we trust in you, Jesus. You're all, you're all, you're all that we need. Your power will pull us through. We're trusting in you. Welcome back, Sunday School families, to another week of our virtual Sunday School. We are so excited that you're here, and we hope that you had a wonderful week and you're doing well. Again, we miss you guys so much, but we're so happy that we can bring you virtual Sunday School. And so today's lesson is about Jesus healing the paralyzed man. So what this story shows us is that first and foremost, Jesus loves us so much that he's willing to stop what he's doing and his teachings to heal someone. And it also shows us how dedicated you can be as a friend. So there was a man who was paralyzed. There was no way he was going to be able to get to Jesus. And his friends and his people took him on a little mat and they brought him to Jesus. They brought him to Jesus by bringing them down from the rooftop. They went above and beyond to get their friend to Jesus. And Jesus noticed it. He saw it. And he made a miracle happen in front of people so they realized that Jesus cares about everyone. This man had been forgotten. This man was living a really rough life being paralyzed. And Jesus saw him, paid attention, and healed him. And so this week, we hope you have a wonderful one. We hope that things are going well with school. We hope that your families are healthy and everything is good. We are so glad that you can be with us for virtual Sunday School, and we'll see you guys next week.
Yay! Nanny, nanny, boo, of mercy. Jesus heals. This is Jesus.
Ohio.
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus did many amazing things. He taught everyone about God's love, healed people from their sickness, and even calmed storms. The news of Jesus had spread all around, and many people wanted to come and see what he was doing. No matter where Jesus went, great crowds of people would follow him. Jesus went to his own town, and news spread that he was back home.
Ow!
Soon, the house where he was staying was packed. So Jesus began to preach God's word to the people. Meanwhile, some men heard that Jesus was in town. So they decided to take their paralyzed friend to him to be healed, for their friend wasn't able to walk.
Excuse me?
Huh?
But when they got to the house, they couldn't reach Jesus because of the crowd.
Oh, well.
No!
So they went to the roof and dug a hole right above Jesus.
We got this.
Then they lowered their friend down into the crowd right in front of Jesus.
Hey, everybody, how's it going?
Jesus saw their faith, so he said, "Son, your sins are forgiven." There were some Pharisees and teachers of religious law in the room, though, and they were horrified that Jesus would say such a thing. They said to themselves, "Who does he think he is? Only God can forgive sins." Jesus knew what they were thinking, so he asked them, "Why do you question this? Is it easier to say to this man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Stand up, pick up your mat, and walk?"
What?
Jesus went on to say that he would prove to them that he was allowed to forgive sins.
Yeah, right.
And so Jesus said to the paralyzed man, "Stand up, pick up your mat, and go home."
Okay.
So the paralyzed man stood up and picked up his mat. The entire room was stunned as the man walked out through the crowd. All were amazed and praised God, saying, "We've never seen anything like this before." And they believed that God had sent Jesus with the authority to forgive sins and the ability to help the hurting.
Now it's our favorite time of Sunday school, and that is to do crafts. I am missing my beloved helpers, but that's okay because they're at home about to do the craft that you guys are about to do too. So you're gonna see in week 4 that there is a craft all about the paralyzed man that we just learned about. This story is one of the very dear stories in the New Testament that just shows Jesus's compassion and love for just anything that can go wrong or can happen. Jesus literally was in the midst of just talking and telling stories and lessons and praying for people. And here comes this opening through the roof of the place he was speaking to. And here's Jesus, who just stops everything and pays attention and heals this paralyzed man. And the other thing about it too, what's so great and one of my favorite parts of the story is that the paralyzed man did not get there by himself. He was led there by his friends, by his people that knew that the only way that he was going to get help was to get to Jesus. And so I hope you guys have some fun with this craft. It's just a fun, silly one, but it shows you just how unique this story is and how awesome of a God we have. So I hope you guys have some fun, and we'll see in a little bit.
Yay! trust in you, Jesus, your own.